makes me very, very glad to have you amongst us.
Paulina Strah.
But I must confess, we do not envy you because you have a very, very difficult mission. We wonder if you are, if at all, you're going to achieve your goals or the mission set out for you. Bilingualism, multiculturalism, vive ensemble. Mr. Chairman, we don't have any problem with bilingualism. We don't have any problem with multiculturalism. We don't, for Christ's sake. We have a problem with vivre ensemble. Not vivre ensemble in the sense of eating achu or eating ndole or wearing the aguada or wearing the Northwest dala. No, that's not the problem. The problem is one of recognition. The Anglophone problem. It's what we have before us. Can you address it like the Anglophone problem? Let us stop deceiving ourselves in this country, where a people freely came to meet their brothers who were already independent so that we could form one country and see how we could forge ahead to leave a better place for our children to come. But what do we have? One of annexation, assimilation, where there's so much ignorance on the history of this country, where there's so much arrogance on the part of a few who are chopping fat on the resources of this country, where there is marginalization, where there is arrogance, I dare say, total arrogance, which is unacceptable. Until we change our ways, there is no way forward for us together. If we do not change our ways, it is unfortunate, Mr. Chairman, that you are only an organ of transmission. I wish you had a lot more powers to be able to effect change. We know you like a man of integrity, but the office given you, the mission given you, should not soil the legacy that you're going to leave behind. Because history tomorrow is going to judge all of you here. Whether you like it or not, history will judge you. What was your contribution to change and development in this country? And if you just sit low and you accept rubbish, you can be certain that we will rub you in mud. History is going to rub you in mud. We have two big problems in this country today. It has to do with words, and which words are followed by actions. Mr. Chairman, who is a terrorist? When we get the definition of who a terrorist is, then we will know who the terrorist is. A terrorist, well, ordinarily speaking, I don't need to go to the dictionary, someone who terrorizes others. There are various forms of terrorism in this country. We know today, natural fact, I was so glad the other day on the 20th of May watching television when I saw sons of terrorists at the Unity Palace. The sons of Umnyobe and NS Wandi, who yesterday were terrorists by the definition of the government of the day. And who today have been rehabilitated. But what happened to them and to their fathers? They were hanged, beheaded. There was a lot of blood. As we are seeing today, we will call freedom fighters terrorists. But we forget to know that the greatest terrorist today in this country, thank God you said we can say what we said, what we like or what we know without any fear of repression. The greatest terrorist today in this country is the state. It is the state. State terrorism is going beyond bounds. It is going beyond bounds. You kill innocent civilians, unarmed civilians. You raise out villages from existence. You sign decrees that people should move out of their homes and go over to where they feel safe. People have to move to the forest. And when people stand up to fight for their rights, to fight for their recognition as citizens of this country, you term them as terrorists. When you term them as terrorists and you send out soldiers with guns behind them, what do you expect? These soldiers are trained to kill. They will kill those innocent people. Because, and they're killing, Mr. Chairman, thank you very much. They're killing because you have sent them out to go and kill. They know how to take instructions. When they take instructions, because you have labeled our children, our brothers, our fathers as terrorists, and then you want to say, oh no, you're not part of that kind of carnage. No, you are. And you will be held squarely responsible for it. I am sorry, those of you who from far and near think you might not have or who directly know they have something to do with it, you will have to answer to history. You will have to answer to history. Terrorism, what I see, I cannot go to my village. Women in the village today have done their farms, have worked their farms. Soldiers come and cut down their crops. Women cannot go to weed their farms. What higher form of state terrorism can we expect? What higher form? And we say that the people are terrorists. There are various forms of terrorism. The amount of money we are spending to check terrorism, to kill people, do we know what that money would have done if it was to do the Bamenda Ring Road that maybe you people promised us? When I say you people, you must excuse me, but you are members of government and you are people of government. So you have come before us. You promised us this road more than 30 years back. And nothing has been done about it. But people should just sit and fold their arms. The amount of corruption we have in this country today. How many people are dying as a result of corruption? A lot more people are dying from corruption than terrorism. A lot more people. Tribalism that we have. Nepotism. All forms of ills. And we say that we want to live together. It's a difficult exercise. And that's why I say I do not envy you. I wish you had a lot more powers. Mr. Chairman, the second point has to do with who is a secessionist. When we get to know who a secessionist is, then we'll get to know who the secessionist is. Seceding from what? From a whole. Means is you're part of something. And you want to break away. If you do not recognize me as a part of a whole, then don't dare you call me a secessionist. The history of Cameroon does not start with German Cameroon. The history of Cameroon does not start with West Cameroon, as it then was, and La République du Cameroun. German Cameroon covered a lot bigger territory. Included even Northern Cameroon today, part of Nigeria, included parts of Chad, parts of the Central African Republic, parts of the Congo, parts of Gabon. Are we going to go out tomorrow to reclaim those parts of German Cameroon? Simply in the name of one and indivisible Cameroon? Nope. It's not possible. It is a spirit. One and indivisible has to be a spirit. You cannot force it by decree. No matter what kind of decree you sign. And when you see the Anglophones, I put it this way, the Anglophone problems, even though you people like to talk of the problems of the Northwest and the Southwest, it is not the problems in the Northwest and in the Southwest. It's the Anglophone problem in this country. We should be honest enough to recognize it, to accept it, and to treat it as such. When you see the Anglophone problem, you must ask yourselves the question, can you really, really stop it just by maybe this commission coming out. It's a difficult mission. No. The Anglophone problem has to do with a spirit. It is intangible. You cannot see it, you cannot touch it. But the Anglophoneness is there in every Anglophone. With your permission, to my dear brothers and friends, so many of you up here, I know you, but I want to let you know that all the Anglophones up here, sitting on this table, you are with us in spirit. Yeah. You are with us in spirit. And our Francophone brothers are fully aware of that. Are fully aware of that. The problem is, how do we live together? How do we live together? Dialogue. Dialogue. So many people have given that suggestion. Dialogue is the answer. And I don't know whether the meeting that we are having together is part of this inclusive dialogue that has been recommended by so many instances. If the meeting that we are having with you here today is part of this dialogue, then I dare say again, it is unfortunate. Because I ask myself the question, those of us who are sitting here and those of you up there, are we truly representative of the two parties involved? Because two parties there are. The Anglophone on one side, not the Francophone on the other side, but the government on the other side. The government. Because like I said before, the Francophone and the Anglophone, they do not have any problem. If there is a problem and we want dialogue, are you and those of us here capable of talking and bringing about a peaceful solution to this problem? If we cannot bring about a peaceful solution to this problem, then we should be honest enough. And there again, you must excuse me. Luckily, the chairman said we should talk not from our lips, but from our hearts. If those of you up there, if it is difficult, if it is impossible for you to achieve this mission, there's one little thing that I grew up learning, enjoying. The spirit of resignation. If it is difficult, we'll call on all of you sitting up here to tender in your resignation from this commission, and you'll be making a major contribution to change in this country. A major contribution. Immeasurable. So we are calling on you to give peace a chance. Call that inclusive dialogue. That inclusive dialogue is going to include all of our brothers and sisters who are in the diaspora. All of them. All of them. Don't exclude anybody. Don't go there with any preconceived ideas of what dialogue is. If we cannot do this, Mr. Chairman, we're in for a lot of problems, please. Mr. Chairman, I remember with a lot of fun, AAC1, AAC2 in Boya and Bamenda, respectively. It looks like we need an AAC3. We need an AAC3. I'm sure you people all know about it because definitely you've read this history. Mr. Chairman, the political prisoners, people who have been moved from Boya Bamenda to super courts in Yaoundé and imprisoned and given long terms of imprisonment. Double standards. But we're talking about Vivre Ensemble. Double standards. Siseko and Co. I don't know, maybe I'll give you a mission to produce them, to produce those people. Maybe if you can just show us a photograph of this commission with our leaders from Nigeria. Mr. Chairman, I will give you Kati Kati that you love so well. Mr. Chairman, I beg you one more time. Let us stop the carnage. The amount of killing that is going on. You cannot, you will kill to the last Anglophone. You will kill to the last. So the military solution is not the answer. It is not the answer. Kill as you wish. You have the might, but you have helped to sensitize our children, and you have helped to radicalize our children. That is why there's confrontation today. That is why there is war. And a lot of people, a lot, are dying on both sides. But we don't have the courage to make the publication. So, Mr. Chairman, I beg you and your commission, you have a responsibility before us and your children to go down in history as people who really try to bring about change, who try to solve this problem, which you identify. You have that responsibility. I know we are always afraid when people talk to us. I mean, when I say we are afraid in this country, when people talk to us about the kind of legacy that we want to leave behind. So, but when you and I, all of us, we sit down in the quiet of our hearts, we should look at the future tomorrow when we are no longer there. What Cameroon do we want to leave for our children? Thank you very much.